discuss. Then the next point what they asked last time is, why so complex process you are doing on diabetes? Why you are doing so complex process on diabetes? Okay, so just I will tell you. And another question also they asked, why you are taking patient's data in order to classify? Why you are taking patient's data in order to classify? Okay, two points I have told you now. Why so complex process you are doing on diabetes? First point. Second point, patient's data. Why you are taking patient's data in order to classify? Okay. So actually this is both patient and non-patient. Both are present here. Patient and non-patient both are present here. This is our input file. This is our input file. Tested positive means diabetes is there. That person is a patient. Tested negative means that patient doesn't have any diabetes. Tested negative means that patient doesn't have diabetes. He is a normal person. Wherever negative is there, all those are normal persons. Wherever positive is there, all those are patients. Okay. I might have given this in another format also. I might have given this file in another format also, where the last column is 1 or 0. Last column is 1 or 0. 1 means with diabetes, 0 means without diabetes. Okay, you might have used this file in your process, because if it is words like this, the coding will not accept the words. When you write coding, it will not understand tested underscore positive, tested underscore negative. Instead of that, if you give numbers 1 and 0, it is very easy for it to understand for the coding. So 1 means with diabetes, 0 means without diabetes. So we are taking both the normal person as well as person with diabetes and making a normalized analysis. So the answer, why you are taking patient's data in order to classify, we are not only taking patient's data, we are taking normal person data also. Next question, why so complex process on diabetes? Okay, we are not doing any complex process. The thing is, we will do this classification, okay, and we will find out accuracy. What accuracy says, whether the patient is having, whether the person is having diabetes or not. Okay, true positive means the person is having diabetes and the algorithm also says he is having diabetes. True negative means the person is not having diabetes and the algorithm says he is not having diabetes. Means diagonal values will tell correctly whether the person is having diabetes or not. In the review also you can explain the same confusion matrix. Diagonally it will give the correct values whether the person is having diabetes or not diabetes. Based on that we will get some normalization. Based on that, for example, you are having some input file, you are executing and finding out what is that normalized value. What is the normalized value I am speaking of is, this is our input file. This is our input file. After operating on this input file, you will get an idea. The algorithm itself will get the normalized value. If a person is having diabetes, what is his plasma level? What is his pressure? What is his insulin level? What is the mass? What is the age? Like that, some range it will fix. Okay, suddenly if I come in front of you and ask you to tell whether I am having diabetes or not, instead of going for testing in the hospital, if I give you my pressure level, my plasma level, insulin level, mass, age, everything, you can put it to the algorithm. Okay, I will give one row value, my details. So instead of going to the hospital and checking for diabetes, if these values are given, your algorithm can tell whether I am having diabetes or not, because you have already done analysis on so many persons in this file. Okay, in this file, you have 9 rows and 768 columns. In the input file, what we have taken, we are having 9 columns and 768 rows. Okay, this 768 people information is there in the input file. 768 people, they may have diabetes, they may not have diabetes. You have to count and know how many 1 is there, how many 0 is there. So you are doing some common analysis in order to get, if a person is having diabetes, what is the plasma level, insulin level, age, mass, etc. If the person is not having diabetes, what is the standard values for this range of values. Okay, And then suddenly, if I come a new person out of this 768, my details are not there in this input file. Okay, I am out of this input file. I'm a new person. If I come and give my details to you, okay, what is the insulin level? What is the my age, mass, and then what is the pressure? Okay, pressure, plasma level, all those details if I give, you can check with the standard values. Okay, whether it is matching with the diabetes case or whether it is matching without diabetes case. That is the application here. Okay, you are just to frame anything, not only this medical application, any application, whoever are doing on, for example, kidney, lungs, or some other brain related, in the classification mainly we will fix the standard values using these algorithms, so that next time when a new person come, we can just identify with the standard values itself. This is pre-detection. This is pre-detection. For example, I will tell you one practical example. Here the first column is pregnant, number of times pregnant, isn't it? I will tell one practical example. For example, we are in Karunyanagar, an unknown lady is there, she is pregnant. Okay, unknown lady is there, she is pregnant, and we don't know whether she will have normal delivery or a cesarean. Okay, whether she will have normal delivery or cesarean, but if we have some analysis already on some 1,000 people, okay, based on the sugar level and the BP level, based on the sugar level and BP level, if this is the sugar level and BP level at the due date, for example, March 30 is the due date. Okay, complete March, if the BP level, sugar level is in this range, then definitely they will have normal delivery. If it is not in this range, it is in another range, then it should be cesarean. Delivery will be difficult, something like that. Okay, if already on 1,000 people this analysis is done and some standard thing is fixed, okay, if some standard values are fixed, suddenly if that detail is there with us, suddenly if somebody tells a Karunyanagar, one lady is very serious, she is facing so much trouble, okay, and it takes 1 hour to travel to Coimbatore, okay, now we can consult the doctor. Now we can consult the doctor, and if we have the BP level and sugar level of that lady here itself, and based on that we can inform the doctor she will be having normal delivery. So you kindly prepare everything whichever required for normal delivery. And if she is going to have cesarean, if we have predicted in Karunyanagar, her case is like all her BP level, sugar level are like this, so definitely it should be a cesarean. We can inform the doctor, kindly prepare all the materials, equipments, instruments required, whichever required for a cesarean process. Okay, this is the practical application what we will be doing. Because until we travel and reach Coimbatore, the lady should not be in trouble. If we predict some analysis, all these are people are doing. This comes under consultancy work. What I am telling you now, it is under consultancy work. Actually, we are not doctors. We are doing some analysis on the classification algorithm, but we are able to help the doctors. Isn't it? You understood my story, the imaginary, not imaginary, this is a real thing which is happening. I heard it from somebody else. That's why I'm confidently telling you. This is the consultancy work. Apart from doctors, some other normal people who are doing research, they are able to help doctors. All the statistics, mathematicians are there. They are doing a lot of consultancy like this using the classification algorithms or some other medical related applications. They are doing research and they are helping the doctors. Okay, this is what we can do. And you can talk in this direction. Why so complex process? Means we are not doing any complex process. All the medical applications are in this direction only. This is the purpose of doing. Why engineers are involved in medical applications? We are not doctors, but why we are involved in medical applications means this is the purpose. We will just find out the standard values, whatever required. Then based on that, we will be able to help the people in medical track. Okay, that is our consultancy work, side track, whatever going on, and reality it is happening. So this is the answer for that question. And then how do you find mean for data? How do you find mean for the data? So mean means average. There is nothing special about that. This is the input data. Mean means average. Okay, we are taking the first column of all the people, 768 people data are there. So all the 768 rows we are taking average. That's all. Sum of the data by number of the quantities. Sum of the quantity by number of the quantities. If you want to find the mean for mass, for this column. If you want to find the mean, you add sum of all the quantities divided by number of the quantities we know, 768. That is how you find the mean. Last time they asked you question, how do you find mean? Okay. And what is your final output in the project? What is your final output in the project? Classification algorithm outputs are in the base paper. It is very clear. Final output is accuracy, okay, precision recall, F1 score. Other name for precision recall is sensitivity selectivity only. You can just check the other names here. You can just check the other names here. Sensitivity means recall. Okay. Sensitivity means other name is recall. Hit rate also sensitivity only. True positive rate means also sensitivity only. Like this, other names are also there in this formulas. You can just check it out. Our final output, I told you now, last time the question is, what is your final output? Our classification algorithm matrix, classification algorithm output, confusion matrix and this metric, confusion matrix and this matrix are the final output in our project, okay? What extra modification you will do? Next question, what they asked is, what extra modification you will do? In the block diagram, I told you, in the base paper, just now, I asked him to change, no? So SVM is there, and these two we have removed in the block diagram. Instead, we have put logistic regression and CNN. That is the additional thing. Apart from base paper, what we are doing, from the base paper, we are taking only SVM and other two, our new implementation, which is not done in the base paper. Okay. What extra modification you will do? Means we are concentrating on, they have done only on ML algorithms. They have done only on ML algorithms. We are doing two ML algorithms and one DL algorithm. That is the separation or a difference with respect to base paper in our work. Okay. So I have discussed all the questions, I think. I have discussed all the questions. Now I will come back to. And just now what I sent, in email is this one. He will put it in the PPT. Okay. Design details, they are asking. You put this heading. You put this heading, data set description. It is multivariate time series type of data. Categorical means 0 and 1. Last column is 0 and 1. Category means 0 category, 1 category. It is an integer value. Okay. All the attributes. These are the attributes in our input file. These are the column names in our input file. How many columns are there? How many rows are there? What each column represents? This first 8 are each column. Okay. And last column, class variable, means it will tell whether the person is having diabetes or not. Okay. Last column tells. Hence, we are writing number of attributes means 8 plus class. Class will give what is the type of algorithm we have to use. Last column, it is 0 or 1. So only two possibilities are there. That's why we are using two-way classification. Okay, only two possibilities, yes or no. Only two possibilities, diabetes present or diabetes not present. Only two possibilities are there. So we are using two-way classification. And that is the class. Last column will specify what is the type of algorithm possibility we can use on the input data. Okay, categorical means I told you category, 0 category, 1 category. And this is the input file. Just now I sent him. He will include that also in the PPT. With this, I will close.